You're watching the Raiders Report, and I'm your host, Mitchell Renz. Please follow me on Twitter, at MitchellRenz365. My next part of the segment is for people who only subscribe to YouTube.com/Raiders Report, because I want to be able to, like, help you guys out, and I want to be able to add you guys onto my show, and I want to be able to have fun. And the only way you're going to be able to watch this, or the only way you're going to be able to be on the show, is if you subscribe to YouTube.com/Raiders Report. My first Raider Nation rumor coming in here is from my dude Brody, okay? And is Chris Warren going to be the starting running back next year for the Oakland Raiders? I'm going to give this one two Chucky heads. People are talking. Warren had a great preseason. He had an NFL-high 292 rushing yards. Unfortunately, he's on the IR right now with a knee injury. But the reason why I think he could potentially be the starter, I'm not a believer in Doug Martin. Jalen Richard sure is filling the gap right now, I think, for the Raiders. He's a great pass-catching running back. I just don't think he's an every-down running back. Warren, when he was coming out of Texas, had some upside. But what I saw from this dude in the preseason was a player who gave it his all every single play. And those are the players that John Gruden freaking loves, which is why I'm giving it to Chucky Head. So, who's going to be the Raiders' starting running back next year? Could it be Warren? Could it be Martin? Heck, maybe it's somebody that's not even on the roster. Maybe it's Le'Veon Bell. Who knows? Who's going to be the Raiders' starting running back next year? Next Raider Nation rumor coming up from Lil Sprite. More of a Coca guy, but hey, I like this question. Is Seth Roberts going to get cut in 2019? I'm going to give this one three Chucky heads, and I think it's pretty likely. I wanted to almost give it four, but I can't 100% guarantee it. In 2018, 17 catches, 180 yards, two touchdowns. In Seth Roberts' entire career, he's never had over 500 receiving yards. And his 2019 contract, $4.65 million. Is Seth Roberts really worth that kind of money? I'm going to tell you straight up, no. Not worth that money. And if the Raiders wanted to cut him in 2019, it is a zero hit to the cap. What does that mean? I think that means Seth Roberts, my man, you're on the way out. Shout out to Mizzen of Maine for hooking us up and every dude here at Chat Sports with these dope dress shirts. Why is it comfortable.af? Because these dress shirts are indeed comfortable as F, and I promise you it is the best damn dress shirt you'll ever buy. Next Raider Nation rumor is coming up from my man Rob, who hits me up quite a bit. So Rob, shout out to you. Is McKenzie on the hot seat? Is McKenzie on the hot seat? I'm going to give this one two Chucky heads. People are talking. Yes and no. When you're looking at a transitional team, sure, there's going to be the bad and there's going to be the good. He's been the GM since 2012, and he has only one winning season during that time, which came in 2016. He's got a regular season record of 37 wins, 66 losses, and he doesn't have a playoff win. When I'm thinking about a GM who just signed a coach like Gruden to as much money as he did, he's absolutely on the hot seat. But at the end of the day, if they are in a rebuild mode, I still like to think that I don't think he's going to get fired, even if the Raiders have a terrible season, unless John Gruden is just like, hey, man, I don't want this guy anymore. Shout out to you, Raider Nation, for checking out the show. I definitely appreciate it. And if you like what you're hearing, follow me on Twitter, at MitchellRenz365.